Even in the most authoritarian states, there is always a tipping point. For Kazakhstan, that point came around a week ago with the rise in fuel prices. Demonstrations led to wider protests against the autocratic regime, leading to President Tokayev dismissing the government and removing former President Nursultan Nazarbayev, a symbol of the state, as head of the Security Council. The country is in ruins. Many people living with less than bare minimum wages.
A fuel price hike fueled agitation led to change of guard and wheels of reforms being set in motion in Kazakhstan. Demonstrations against a fuel price rise began just over a week ago before erupting into a wider protest against Tokayev's government and the man he replaced as president, 81-year-old Nursultan Nazarbayev. Burnt-out vehicles and buildings paid testament to days of violence. Thousands have been detained and public buildings torched during mass anti-government protests over the past week. Seen as a satellite state of Russia, Kazakhstan looked to Moscow for help. A Russia-led alliance of ex-Soviet states, the Collective Security Treaty Organization, sent troops to restore order. An intervention that comes at a time of high tension in Russia and the United States over the Ukraine crisis.
Of course, we understand the events in Kazakhstan are not the first and far from the last attempt to interfere in the internal affairs of our states from the outside. The measures taken by the CSTO have clearly shown we will not allow situation to be rocked at home.
As the unrest mounted, President Tokayev attempted to ease the crisis by announcing a 180-day cap on fuel prices, sacking the country's cabinet and firing Nazarbayev from his post of head of the National Security Council. He ordered a corpus for reforms to be funded by the very same oligarchs who amassed wealth at the cost of an entire nation's well-being. More than half the wealth of Kazakhstan is outside the scrutiny of the government, controlled by Nazarbayev, his family and close coterie of people. For nearly three decades following independence, the country was run by Nursultan Nazarbayev, a former Communist Party Politburo member with strong links to Russian President Vladimir Putin. President Nazarbayev resisted any move to introduce more democracy. Public protests in Kazakhstan are illegal without a government permit, and previous strikes and demonstrations were dealt with very harshly. The president erected statues of himself and built a new capital, Astana, which was later renamed Nursultan in his honor. As a week of deadly unrest, Russia-led forces who were sent to quell riots are preparing to withdraw as President Tokayev nominated a new prime minister. There are fears within the international community that the Russia-China support to Kazakhstan will not bode well for an independent Central Asia.
It is clear that it is not in the European interest for the Central Asian state to become unilaterally dependent on Russia or China. On this too, we will and must have a close exchange between our two countries.
But change of guard in no way means change in the way things are run in the country. Nazarbayev's daughter, Dariga, became Senate Speaker a day after his resignation, suggesting she might become the long-term successor.